just kind of wish, honestly, and again, this is coming from someone that likes Jimmy Dore, I wish that he was more willing to just have an honest engagement with people, because I really would love to see that exchange of ideas, you know, regardless of winning or losing or stylistic points. Like, is it crazy to want to watch two people engage that both have a big following, that are both obviously very confident in their beliefs? And I think they both really do believe what they're saying. I don't think that either of these people are necessarily grifters at all. Like, I do believe they're coming from a genuine place. And it just does, I don't know, it just does suck that they can't just, you know, have a discussion.
Yeah, well, that's I think the problem is, right? Yeah, no, just to kind of echo what Kamali said, is I think you raised a lot of really good points as to why Jimmy probably doesn't want to do this, right? Because, you know, like somebody put in the comment section, like, Sam Seder went to law school. Like, you kind of learn how to litigate and do all those things really well if you're kind of taught the structures of this is how, you know, and it's one of the things we give credit to Vosh a lot for. Vosh just knows how to fucking pin somebody in an argument and back you into a hole. You'd be like, I don't want to vote for Joe Biden. He's a fascist. Well, what do you define fascism? Like, oh, well, you know, he will catch you for saying shit that you can't immediately articulate 100% of them, and it's like, okay, well, you know, I was just talking, oh, well, look, so you're not serious about what you say. Those kinds of things happen all the time in a debate, and if you're not super seasoned, like Sam Seder deals with call-ins all the time, so I think that that's a good point. What sucks about Jimmy is that he wants to throw bombs all the fucking time, but it's like, sit down in a chair and actually talk to somebody, and like, let's be reasonable and like talk about our fucking ideas a little bit and not just scream into a camera and at somebody else. Like, let's actually engage in a discussion. I like screaming into my camera as much as the fucking next guy. Right. I do it every single goddamn day. But I'm also happy to sit down and be like, all right, you think that we disagree on like so much shit. Right. So we have Spike Cohen. We've had Ryan Grimm. We've had a bunch of people on that we don't agree with on everything. Right. I don't care about that. I'm happy to talk to anybody about this. You know, so, you know, maybe if I have you know what I'm saying? Like, there are some people I just don't think are worth talking to at all. Right. Like Gavin and I have said a bunch of times, like, we're not interested in debating somebody like Destiny. That's just a waste of fucking time at this point. But like, you know what I mean? Like, for the most part, I'll just fucking, you know, I'll talk to you. And I don't understand why Jimmy won't just kind of like at least occasionally embrace that kind of attitude where it's like, okay, maybe I won't talk to Sam Seder because I have this like visceral personal hatred of him and everybody at TYT. But can you not find somebody like with a similar political line of thinking? Like, why can't you sit across from David Pakman, somebody you've never like gone to blows with, and be like, I think your entire ideology is like bullshit. Let me systematically fucking take you down. Because David Pakman doesn't really strike me as like an alpha male kind of guy that's going to be able to like debate super well, right? Like, you know, like that would give Jimmy the edge of being like, oh, he's the fucking, you know, I don't know. But I'm just saying, like, it would be better to see him like actually bounce his ideas off again. Because one of the things Gavin's pointed out to me a lot, is that Jimmy actually had some of his most shining moments when he was talking to Cenk Uygur or somebody on the Young Turks back in the day, which I wasn't like a regular viewer of, but he does. He comes across as like super thoughtful and thorough and just not the personality that he adopts on his show now. And I think he should at least consider tapping back into that. To
yeah.